Welcome everyone to this joint webinar hosted by Toradex, and the topic for today's webinar is KnowCode AI using computer vision and AI to convert graphical user interfaces sketches into real embedded applications. We have with us today our guest and partner, TotalCross. Let me introduce me. I am Matheus Castello, and I am embedded software developer at Toradex. And also let me introduce you to our main presenter for today, and that is Bruno Muniz, who is CEO of TotalCross. And if you don't know yet, TotalCross is an open source cross platform, and TotalCross offers this open source cross platforms solutions for is develop graphical user interface. But of course, Bruno will do a good introduce about TotalCross for you today. Before diving into the webinar, let me cover a few organization points. Please use the chat window of this webinar too if you have any technical issues and wish to let us know. At the end, we will also do a Q&A session. You can type your question in the chat window anytime, and we will pick them up at the end. The webinar will be recorded and made available for on-demand viewing. All right, with this, let's get started. I will begin with a very brief overview of Toradex is and what we do. Toradex is focusing on making embedded computing easy to use, so you can get simple access to the latest technology for your product development. We are doing so by providing readily reliable ARM system models and including software and support. We are striving to offer the lowest cost of ownership to you, and this don't just mean the model price, but also consideration of aspects like your development effort, time to market, and long-term maintenance. And we are proud of being able to have an industry-leading support, including a very active community and a developer page with over 800 articles that is updated daily. And as you can see on this slide, we have offices around the world with local support and warehouses. And in this slide, we have a short overview of our products. We have three system model families. Inside these families, the models are all being compatible. And so you can simply scale from i.MX 6 over i.MX 7 and to the i.MX 8. We are also providing production quality software and with these models, but we will learn more about this later. And let me also list here our focus applications as we are optimizing our products and offerings for them. Industrial automation, healthcare, transportation, test and measurement, and smart cities. Typical projects are customers with volume requirements of a few hundreds to a few thousands of products per year. Toradex itself has thousands of active customers. Apart from our awesome system of models, Toradex also provides production-ready software, including reference images for the Kyoto project. Toradex is also active in mainlining and upstreaming code for its system models. And we have also Horizon, that is a brand new free offering from Toradex, and it's an open source and easy to use industrial Linux platform. Horizon focuses on lowering your time to market and can be used out of the box. It's based on open source software, so you have no lock-in and you can adjust it to your needs. Horizon comes with an automotive grade update client to allow for simple, safe, and secure software updates. As an example, software updates are safe even if you lose power in the worst possible moment. And security is another focus. Frequent updates and simple access to hardware security features that make it easy for you to develop a secure device. And also we have a real-time option available for Toradex. Modern continuous integration and verification process makes sure that every Toradex release is stable. And Toradex is built with the Yocto project and utilizes Docker for software containerization, deeping into a vast software ecosystem. So, okay, this is the overview. Let's pass the stage for our partner, Bruno Muniz from TotalCross.
Hi, hello everyone. First of all, I want to thank Toradex for this opportunity to talk to you. Also, we are partners of Toradex since 2019, and I'm sure they are one of the greatest reference in the market. And today we're gonna talk more about AI to build GUI, and I want to talk briefly about TotalCross. So who are we? So TotalCross builds an ecosystem of technologies and services for GUI implementation on embedded systems. We are focused to optimize time for the developer, for the embedded engineer, and to create an ecosystem of technologies, some of them open source, to help them to build GUI faster. So we strongly believe that time is more valuable than money. So that old saying that time is money, we don't believe that, especially because on this embedded market, we know to build GUI takes a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of development knowledge, and we believe we need to provide solutions to decrease this time to market, to make solutions faster in the market. Also, the GUI implementation is really time consuming, and embedded engineers don't want to invest time on it. We spend a lot of time interviewing the developers, engineers, talking to people to know more, and we find out that the engineers, they want to develop the entire application, they want to deliver the solution to the market. The GUI is one part of the solution, of course, it's a really important part, but it's not the most important part. And that's why we want to optimize this development part. And our main goal today is to provide tools and technologies to reduce up to 80% of time in the GUI implementation, especially for low-end devices. So with Toradex, we are running since the i.MX6 ULL with no GPU until the i.MX8 with Toradex and everything. And how do we do this? As I said, we have open source technologies. We have a GUI framework to help developers and engineers to build it in a fast and easy way. It's TotalCross. You can search for it on GitHub. We also use a really interesting license. We use LGPL to make you use the software without any fee, without any restriction, including on the device. There is no runtime fee, so you can use it to create your application. And also, we provide some services to help you to create the GUI, including the performance raise on our technology, also to reduce the footprint, and designing service that includes the no-code technology that I want to show you. Also, we are affiliated of the Linux Foundation. We are inside the AGL, Automotive Grade Linux. And as I said, we are partners of Toradex, a great partner. And I want to ask you a quick question. We're gonna have a few polls during this presentation just to know more about our audience. So if you could answer, will be really, really interesting for us. So how likely are you to use a code generator tool to build a GUI? never, a few times, most of times, always. We're gonna give you a few seconds so you can answer this quick poll. Awesome, thanks for answering. And the most voted was few times after most times. So this is a really, really interesting results, because we are going to show today a tool to help you to build the GUI in an easy and fast way, make some automations. This is exactly what I want to show you. KnowCode is a computer vision algorithm to build embedded GUIs in seconds. So basically, we created a service, a cloud service, with AI, machine learning, computer vision, neural networks to process images, as I will show you right now. So basically, how do engineers create a GUI today? There are two ways. First, writing code directly, and second, using drag and drop tools. But these two ways are time consuming. It takes a long time to create the GUI to test, to run on the simulator, and even to run on the real device, right? And how do we create GUI? As I said, we use computer vision to detect all the elements on the screen, on your GUI prototype, and then we export directly the GUI to the tool that you want to use. So basically, KnowCode is not a design tool, a new design tool. We know designers, they already have their own preference to build the UI. They want to use Adobe XD, Photoshop, Figma, or any other design tool. Also, KnowCode is not a GUI framework. We know that if you want to use your preference, the developer wants to use his preference. That's why we integrate KnowCode with different technologies, like, for example, TotalCross. Also, we can run with NXP GUI Guider. So basically, the process starts with a simple prototype, and we just need the image of the solution. A simple PNG file is enough for us. We don't need the file from the design tool. After that, KnowCode will process this file, this image file, and then it will export to the target technology. So as I said, today we are exporting to TotalCross and also to XP GUI Guider for MCUs. Also, as we run with TotalCross, we can run with Horizon from low-end devices like i.MX 6 ULL to i.MX 8 with Horizon, with Yocto, different distributions. And one really important thing is that KnowCode is agnostic. So if a new design tool is launched, we can easily work with it. Also, we can integrate with other GUI frameworks as well. And this is really important, because you are not locked with any tool in both sides. So it's time to show more about how we do this. Let me share my screen. Let me show a little bit more how can we build this in practice. So as I said, KnowCode is a cloud service that we use to build the GUI. First, we need a prototype, a simple prototype. Here we have a printer.png. It's a printer machine that we want to build. Also, we need the assets that we use, like the icons, the images that we use to build the prototype, like this button, this scan button. After that, we can choose the technology we want to use. We are also making some tests with Flutter. Let's choose TotalCross. Also, we can use the Adobe XD file you can send to us. But here I'm going to use the screenshots and the image assets. So let's fill the form. Also, it's possible to send more than one screenshot. We can process more than one screenshot. You just need to send us a flowchart to let us know what is the flow between the different screens. Let's submit the project. So basically, a robot will take a look at the files and make a process with your image. After that, a human will make the next interaction to see if everything is mapped on the real application. And after that, we're gonna deliver to you in your email the project done. So the project will be ready to run on your IDE and you can compile to your target device. But let's take a look on our cloud service, what happened in practice. So basically, as I said, we received the prototype. So the prototype is here, it's the same, it's the printer.png. Also the assets are here. And let's run manually what the bot do automatically. I will run it just to show you what happened in practice. So here, as I said, we built an algorithm with machine learning, computer vision, is different layers to read the image prototype. So let's type printer.png. Is it starting to process the image to detect all the elements? So basically today we can detect like more than 10 different kind of elements, like buttons, text, sliders, different components on the screen. And as you can see here, all the components are detected. Some of them are image buttons. In this case, the image button scan, it already detects the asset, the icon that I'm using. And this is really important to save time. You don't need to map anything. So it's the same name, the B scan. So as I said, we have different layers to make it easier to build the GUI. Also, we detected text, the size fonts, the colors, the background. So we put all together and we export a file. In this simple application, we are exporting to TotalCross. So it will create an XML file. It's here, printer.xml. And it will create a Java file too, which will read this XML file. And of course, if you want to do any change on the UI later, it's just change the XML file. You don't need to use NoCode again, it's just change the XML file with all components. So let's run this project now on my VS Code, just to take a look closer to the files and to see what is the real image after the creation. So basically, you're gonna receive a package like this, printer application. We can open on VS Code. To open the application, we just need a TotalCross plugin, which is available at VS Code Marketplace. And you can run the application and deploy it on the device. So let's take a closer look to the files. So this is the main application, is the printer application. All the assets are here. The B-scan button that we use. Also the layout, the printer.xml. And again, if you want to make any changes, you just need to change this XML file. Let's run the simulator to take a look at the real application, how it will look like and also how it will behave. So here's the simulator. of TotalCross is really close the real application. Let's open the prototype to check everything. The application is really, really similar. Now let's run this on my device. Also, if I need to integrate anything and add actions to the buttons, this is the class. Or I can create more classes to make integrations. So let's run on my device right now. Let's use the package command from TotalCross plugin. And this command will compile everything to run on the device. TotalCross use Java as a programming language, but we don't use Java on the device. So basically we have a machine. We convert everything, all the bytecodes, to TotalCross format, exactly to lower the footprint on the device and to increase the performance. And we're going to see in a few seconds what is the results of the compilation. And this process also put everything that we need. So it only take 46 seconds. Let's take a look in the files. Just to explain a little bit more. So basically you can run on Android, Windows, Linux 64 or Linux 32. This is the files. Let's take a look briefly. The entire application has 12 megabytes on the device to run on the device. Also, let's take a look on the files. So we have the executable file, which is 9 megabytes. Our virtual machine has 8 megabytes. The rest are assets that we need to run in the compiled application. Also, we need to use TotalCross plugin to deploy on the device. You can deploy directly. We just need to inform the IP, the device, password, user. It's deploying. Let me show you. Let me share the screen of my device. So here we have the device. It's deploying the application. This is an i.MX ULL, no GPU. So the application is running. Of course, there's no interaction right now as we just have one screen, right? But it's really easy to deploy. And the best part is that really easy to build the entire application. So now let me show the full application. Let me show the full simple application for you to show more about the interactions, about other images, other screens. So let's open the full project. This project is available at GitHub. If you want to take a look at the simple app, it's github.com/TotalCross. Let me open the printer application. As I said, you can send more than one UI, more than one screen. So KnowCode AI can process a lot of different screens. In this simple application, we built the application with 20 different screens. Okay, so let's run the simulator again to see more in different UIs that we build with KnowCode. Opening the simulator. Also, it's really interesting to say about the transitions. As we use the runtime, the transitions are uh, the GUI framework. In TotalCross, you already support a lot of different transitions, but you can use a lot of different ones. As I said, we have more than 20 different screens here. Okay. And if you want to edit, you can use the XML, or you can open this XML using Android Studio. Okay. If you want to make to edit this visually, you can use Android Studio. Also, we are deploying a new plugin for VS Code. It will be released this month to help you to edit the XML directly on VS Code. I'm packaging the application again to deploy it on the device to let us see the interaction of more than one screen on the device. And as I said, you can connect this to a backend using different technologies like REST connection with JSON, or you can connect directly calling scripts, Python scripts, or you can connect directly with a JNI, connecting with your C, C++ library. So let's deploy again on the device. Let me share again my screen. So the application is running with different screens, different interactions. Let me share. Let's come back to my slides. Awesome. This was a short presentation about how to use no-code and also how do we build the AI system to read the XML, to read the image. Also, we are applying this to a lot of different use cases. This is a case built together with Toradex. It's a client in Brazil that creates healthcare devices. And we built this application in less than 1 hour. It was 40 minutes to build the entire application running on the device. This is really important to say. So the entire GUI was built with no code. And the only thing they need to do was to connect with the backend that they already had. So this way, no code can reduce up to 80% of time in GUI development using AI machine learning. Also, as I said, this is not a new tool for the designer. We know that the designer wants to use his tool, also the developer wants to keep using his own platform. So it's a service, it's a cloud service to help you to build GUI in an easy and fast way and go to the market faster. A little bit about the history of no-code. We started this in 2019 as an academic research to use computer vision to convert a prototype. We started to apply this for mobile devices, mobile applications. Then we go to embedded applications too. Also in 2020, we created the AI, also the Android XML integration. This year, we already integrated with GUI Guider LVGL, and we have plans to integrate with more technologies. So if you have suggestions of technologies, of GUI technologies, just send to us. We are really open for this. And this year, we are opening to provide this as a service to people. So we are making this GUI creation and send you back the entire solution. Also, On at the end of this year, we want to provide this as a cloud service that you will be able to do it by yourself. But for now, we are running the AI, making the few adjustments, and send you the project done. Okay. Also, I want to make a quick poll. How likely are you to outsource your GUI implementation, just to know more about you and about your issues with GUI implementation? I'm gonna give a few seconds. Thank you for the answers. Few times, never, and most times. Awesome. So as I said, we are providing no code as a service, but also we are doing the entire process of designing since the first prototypes, since to create the low fidelity prototype to go to the high fidelity prototype using Adobe XD. If you need help with this, definitely we can help you. After that, we are also working with KnowCode AI to translate, to export this UI design to real applications. And also, we are working to connect the GUI implementation with your backend too. Also providing reduction of the footprint, optimization of the footprint, and also performance raise on the device. Our vision is to provide the fastest way to build GUI for embedded devices, for engineers, for developers, for companies. And if you want to know more about TotalCross and also KnowCode, we have a community, we have a forum, and we have a Telegram group to discuss about GUI in general, not only about TotalCross. If you want to know more about LVGL, Qt, or any other GUI framework, we are open in this Telegram group. Also, my last tool here for you to know more about the what do you think about this kind of solution about KnowCode AI. So thanks. Whoa, that is nice. So most people like it, this kind of solution. This is really, really amazing. So thanks for the support. And if you need help, like I said, definitely we can help you to create the first UI and, or to deliver your GUI on your device. Okay, thanks for your time, and we are open for questions.
Awesome. Very cool tool, Bruno. And I have a few questions here. Okay, so let me see here the questions. Where's the questions? Here. Okay. First one, address for you, Bruno. Does KnowCode use the approach of Skia to draw the components?
Yeah, with TotalCross, we use Skia to draw all the components, yes. But if we use different tool like GUI Guider from NXP, we don't have any relation with the GUI rendering. It's their tool. We are just creating the project. But with TotalCross, we are using Skia, yes.
Cool. Next one. How does it work in terms of runtime? Is there any fee about it?
Yes, TotalCross, there's no fee for use TotalCross. As I said, TotalCross is purely open source under LGPL v2.1. So it's less restrictive than GPL. So it's really easy to use. You don't need it. You don't need to open your source code to use it. And also there's no fee for the runtime too. So basically it's free and open source.
Cool. And next question. What is next to come for KnowCode? Supporting for more UI elements or also generating behavior?
Yeah, for the roadmap of KnowCode, we want to support more GUI tools and also to support a few more elements like shards, gauge, and more. But this is our roadmap for KnowCode, and also improve the percentage of the of our neural network. This is the main important part to make it more precise.
Awesome. Next one. How do you charge KnowCode AI?
Yes, KnowCode is charged by screen. So if you have a project with 2-10 screens, of course, it's different prices. As we are providing this as a service today, we are more open to provide some quotation to people that want to build the GUI with KnowCode. But I can guarantee that time, and the value will be really lower than creating by code as the simple application that I show.
Yeah. Okay, next one. How can I maintain the code after using the KnowCode AI?
As I said, KnowCode doesn't use any proprietary formats, or we also don't export real code, like source code. We always export an intermediary format. For TotalCross, it exports an Android XML, so you can easily maintain this with Android Studio, with also with our plugin that will be released. And for LVGL, for example, for GUI Guider, we also export a JSON file. And so it's really easy to maintain, to update, and to make changes. This is really important because if the first version of KnowCode, you can do a lot of different changes on the UI as your project evolves. So you are not attached to TotalCross in any way.
Cool. And next one. Can KnowCode generate C++ and C code?
Yes, we made some tests to create code directly using LVGL, and it was really interesting. But as developers, we prefer to provide an intermediary code. That's why we didn't put this on our web page. But if you who sent this question wants to make a test with LVGL, just talk to us, send us an email. We can help you with the GUI and make a proof of concept with your UI for C, C++.
Yeah, cool. Next one. Is there a list of which functions KnowCode can already detect?
Yes, on our GitHub, we have a list of functions, and we support more than 10 different components on the screen, like buttons, text box, text views, image, slider, progress bar. So different components, and we are adding more, especially from specific tools.
And this one is about the internals of the KnowCode. What is the training data source for the KnowCode AI?
Yes, the training, we have a large data set with more than 100,000 images that we use to build this neural network. This is the secret behind KnowCode, is the training data set that we use. We spend a lot of time to do it, and also to improve it, to improve the data set, to have these results that we have today.
Awesome. This one is interesting. KnowCode AI versus Qt. KnowCode AI is advantageous in terms of simplicity only?
Yeah, the main idea here is to be agnostic. So Qt is attached to Photoshop, to Adobe XD, or any other tool. But our main idea is to work with any other tool, design tool, and also to help with system migration. So if you want to migrate one system to another, from one technology to another, we can use just the screenshots, run KnowCode AI, and it's good to go to the other platform. So it's a different approaches. So basically, from our side, we are not attached to any tool. If Adobe XD change his format, for example, KnowCode will keep working properly. So it's different approaches.
Cool. Next one. What is the problem with implementing a GUI on embedded device? There are plenty of tools like GUI Guider from XP, DogeGFX from ST, Qt for MSUs, the tools to generate code for GUI.
Yes, there are a lot of tools, but even, like I said, developers and engineers can create the GUI today basically in two ways. Or they're going to write the code directly, or they're going to use a drag and drop tool. But both of this case, it's really time consuming. That's what we are aiming to solve, to reduce this time to go to market. So only one screen can take from 4 hours to several days to be done. And as I show you, we can build the UI in just a few minutes. So that's the real problem with GUI implementation. And as I said, no code didn't come to compete with the frameworks. It comes to help, to be the first step before the graphical tool. So it helped the developer to start the project, not from the zero, but from the from the starting point.
Awesome. And I think it's the last one. Does this also work with wireframes?
Yes, we made some tests with wireframes, but we always prefer to run a real high fidelity GUI because it can provide a real user experience to the user. Wireframe, it can be done, but no-code also has the ability to detect some colors, size of text, and everything. So it will be not hard for the AI, but it will be worse for the user that will use the software. So we always prefer to, if a client has a wireframe, we prefer to do the high fidelity job and then run with no code.
Awesome. Yeah, I think we are done with the Q&A section. And thanks all to attend to this webinar. Thanks, Bruno.
Yes, thank you, Toradex. Also, thanks, Mateus, to be this amazing host for us. Thanks, Toradex, for this opportunity. And thanks for the audience, too, that's watching the webinar. And see you soon.
Bye-bye. Yeah, very cool. Thank you all, and bye-bye.